Well, it may not feel like it yet, but the monsoon is here. At least it's here officially. What can we expect from this go-round of summer storms, we ask? ASU climatologist Randy Cerveny. It's that time of year, Randy. The brain just fries when you're outside. And you're telling me at June 15th, the monsoon came. Who knew?
Well, for old-timers, you remember that we used to work with dew points.
Yes.
And we had to have 3 days where the dew point was 55 degrees or higher, because that told us how much moisture was in the air. But that got to be too much of a hassle for the public to kind of comprehend. And so we've gone to a set date, kind of like hurricane season now. We just say the monsoon starts on June 15th.
So you basically dumbed it down for us, is what you're saying. Yeah, that's what you're saying.
We still keep track of the dew points.
And it ends September, is it ends September 30th, is that right?
Yes, that's
okay.
Correct.
And that's because usually they don't go into October.
Right, because what happens is we start getting systems coming in from California, from the west, on the westerlies, and we lose that southerly flow that we have with the monsoon.
Okay, last year it seemed like it was good for northern Arizona and maybe southeastern Arizona, but not so much for the Phoenix area. Am I getting that right?
Yeah, it was lackluster to normal. Monsoon. Some places got normal precip. A lot of places didn't. We didn't have anybody that really got really great monsoon rainfall.
It was better than the previous year, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
That was really bad.
We didn't have one.
Yeah. Real quickly, before we get to some maps and some forecasts here, the heat island effect, which obviously we know about the heat aspect of this, does that impact monsoon storms?
Not really. I mean, when you the amount of heat that the city puts out compared to the energy that's associated with a monsoon thunderstorm is like a candle to a power plant. So it's really not enough heat to cause a big change in the monsoon.
And the monsoon, again, comes up from Mexico. And as we've talked about in the past, we have to have these crazy 115, 16, whatever they are, temperatures, even higher, because that's what's needed to pull the moisture up, correct?
Yeah, and actually we can see the first signs of the monsoon. I think we have a...
Yeah, let's go to that first graphic if we can. So we're starting to see it bubble up a little bit.
We are starting to see it along the west coast of Mexico. We're actually starting to see some clouds now. And as we see over the next few days, those clouds are going to increase and work their way further north and eventually come into the Phoenix area.
Is it usually the western side of Mexico where you see these clouds first?
Yes, because the moisture is coming up from the Gulf of California and from the Pacific Ocean.
Okay, and when do you think we might see a little bit of something?
Well, if we go to the next graphic.
The next one is the 8 to 14. Look at you, running this program. 8 to 14 day forecast. Can we get that up? There we go.
Look at that.
Well, that doesn't look too bad.
So we're looking at next week, later on next week, we're going to start to see some monsoon moisture coming into the southeast part of Arizona. And there's a chance that Tucson and Phoenix could actually get a little bit of rain. Likelihood is the Flagstaff won't. It takes another week or so before it'll get up.
But that's encouraging to see right there.
That is very encouraging to see.
Our next graphic, I beat you to this one. Our next graphic, though, talks about the overall monsoon. If we can get to that one, because I have a question. Okay, Randy, I mean, I wasn't born yesterday here. I can't understand why the entire Southwest looks like it's one thing, and we're above. What's going on with that?
Well, that's believe it or not, that is actually a classic monsoon image right there, because what it's showing is that we're getting the moisture coming up, being shot up through the Gulf of California and into Arizona. So the rainfall that we get over Arizona during the monsoon isn't related to anything else that goes on in the western part of the country. So we are kind of living in our own little world during the summertime.
But it looks like a 9-year-old drew that little thing up there saying, I want Arizona to get all the weather. And Arizona looks like it could get all the weather,
It could. And what we do is we notice that we're not showing you Mexico there, because what we would see is that blue above normal, or that green above normal area for Arizona, extends all the way down into Mexico.
Yeah. Okay. So, all right. So it's not just, not stopping at the border.
Exactly.
All right. Our next graphic is dust. This is really interesting. A dust storm ranking system, kind of like what? Hurricanes?
Exactly. What we have done over the last 2 years, believe it or not, is we've gotten almost all of the meteorologists from the Valley. With TV, we've gotten people at SRP, we've gotten people at the National Weather Service, we've gotten people at the Maricopa County Flood Control District, and we've gotten them all together and we said, we need to come up with a ranking system for dust storms. so that we can tell what are the bad ones and what are the not so bad ones.
Yes. And so if we can look at that graphic again, please, on the far right side is the category one. That's just your run-of-the-mill standard issue, right?
Right. About 60% of all dust storms are going to classify out as a category one.
But the further left you go, the bigger and the more haboob we're seeing, huh? The haboobs.
Exactly. So that by the time we get to a category five, in the last 15 years, when we were looking over all the dust storms that have occurred in the last 15 years, only two of them ranked out as category five. One was during the Yarnell fire. Yeah. It kind of didn't make the news because the Yarnell fire that killed the firefighters kind of pushed everything else off. And the second category five dust storm that we had was just a couple years ago when the ASU football game
was
canceled because of a dust storm.
I remember that.
And that was a category five. We have had only one category six storm in the last 15 years.
Let's take a look at it, because we have a shot of that category one storm, and that was in, 2011?
And it's a category six, I think I missed.
Category six. Look at that thing.
That is the infamous July 5th, 2011 haboob. That's the one that made international news when it occurred. And what we're doing is we're basing our ranking on the concentration, how much dust is in the air. And we have very good monitors now across the Valley Network that can measure these things. This thing came out to be just incredible in terms of the amount of dust that was in the air for that storm.
Well, it'll be really interesting then to hear that it's a dust storm warning, it's a category one. Dust storm warning, it's a category three, or whatever it is. We now know what you're talking about.
We're going to be able to do this after the fact, not before.
Oh, really?
Okay. So it's going to be like tornadoes. When we go in and look at the day after a storm, we're going to be able to say, oh, this was a category six dust storm or a category five. We're not yet going to be able to forecast.
Okay, so when you're cleaning out your pool, you know, you'll find out whether it's a two or a three. Okay.
Exactly.
All right, Randy, great information. Good to have you here as we look forward to the summer rains. Thank you, sir.
Thanks.